So we are in another lockdown in London. It's been super stressful these days because we are lockdown after lockdown after lockdown. When I started to recover my clients, I lost them again. Not lost them, obviously they're gonna be postponed, but we all need to pay bills. So I talked time ago about the importance of not relying on clients always. We had to adapt to 2021 and we have to find a way to get money without having to rely on clients. So in this video, I'm gonna show you exactly what I'm working on these days during the lockdown again to set up an online business and all the things you can do as a photographer or creative to earn monthly income from different streams without having to rely on clients. So the first thing I want to tell you guys is that you have to really skill up. You have to learn new things. If you are just working with clients for now as a photographer, you're gonna have to learn a lot of new stuff. During the first lockdown, I've been super productive. I've been studying so many courses in marketing, in social media, how to do a shop online, how to make money online as well, through different income streams. So you're gonna have to learn new stuff and you have to do it. Because if you are just waiting for things to come back to normal, it's like waiting for a slow death. And I'm sorry to say this, but I don't think things are gonna come back to normal, or at least not very soon. So or you adapt or you die in the industry. You know what I mean? So please study, put the effort right now. There is so many lockdowns, so I'm sure you have free time right now. Put the time to learn new things. It's what I'm doing and it's working. And now I'm building up a lot of stuff I'm gonna show you now, but please skill up. There is so many amazing websites to sign up to learn new courses. One of them I'm sure you heard about, almost for sure, because everyone promoted, is Skillshare. I'm there myself, I pay monthly, it's quite cheap as well. And you have courses of every kind. If you wanna learn photography, how to build a shop online, depending on the software you want to use, you're gonna have millions of courses regarding that software. So please sign up there, or there is any others. By any way, I'm gonna put the Skillshare link below so you can see it. Otherwise, there is another one called Udemy, which is very good for courses. But please take the time to learn. That's the first thing, because the things I'm gonna show you, probably you don't know how to do them, but you're gonna be able to learn. It's what I did, it's what I've been doing during the lockdowns, and I've been very productive. So please do the same, adapt, and don't rely on client work. So I'm gonna say everything in priority order for me, what I think is more important, and then I'm gonna go to the things like I didn't do yet, but I may do when I finish the first ones. So the first one, it would be to build a shop online. Build a shop online doesn't mean you have to sell t-shirts, hoodies, or prints. If you like to travel like me, and I like to travel a lot, move around, don't rely on the same place too long, I move a lot. So if you rely on physical products, what is gonna happen is if you want to move, you're gonna have to make sure you put somewhere in charge to send those products over. So you don't wanna do that because obviously you're gonna lose a lot of money hiring people to take care of that. Build a digital product shop. What you can sell, for example, one of the things, one of my favorites I'm building right now, is ebooks. In the ebooks, you can do tutorials, you can do courses, you can teach whatever you want. There is so many ideas out there. If you don't know how to do ebooks, again, go to Skillshare or whatever website you like to learn. My favorite software for ebooks is Affinity Publisher. I used to use InDesign, but I found Affinity Publisher is non-subscription. You pay and you own it and that's it. And to be honest, I didn't find anything I was missing from InDesign. So I'm gonna put the link below and you can take a look. And it's very good for building ebooks, to do graphic design, editorial design is quite good. Everything editorial related. Anyway, so ebooks is a very good product to sell online because everyone loves to have it in their phones when they are traveling around to read, and I think it's very good. And then the second thing could be, for example, video courses. Take the time to do videos. For example, I'm doing YouTube videos, but then I wanna go in depth with some subjects about my photography. And I wanna record videos about portrait photography or how I do certain lighting setups. So I'm gonna record videos and then I'm gonna sell those videos online as well. So it's a lot of work because you're gonna have to hire maybe a place to be able to record properly and do high quality videos. You're gonna have to spend maybe a bit, or maybe they can lend you a place, or a friend of yours has a really nice house and you can do it there. You don't have to spend money really if you have a camera to record yourself. And then you can record those courses, and once you do the hard work, and as I said before, you have to be patient, it's a lot of work for free. But then once you build the shop and you put the video courses there, you just have to wait. And maybe they sell, you know? That's why you have to upgrade and you have to learn the world online and grow your online presence. So you can sell video courses as well. And another thing you can sell is photography and creative resources. This means could be Lightroom presets, could be actions in Photoshop, brushes, textures. I love to put textures on my pictures. So you can take pictures of textures, like a brick wall, like wood, and then you can sell those textures to people because people buy them for the photography or creative work or graphic designers as well. So shop online for me is the one to go. Right now I'm rebuilding my whole website. I'm migrating my domain to Squarespace. I used to do with WordPress, but I found like Squarespace is very quick to build a website. It's very, very good. And even though I'm web designer myself and I used to do with WordPress everything myself, now I don't have the time. So I'm passing to Squarespace because it's way quicker. And the shop online is very easy to build with the Squarespace. So that's what I'm gonna do right now, guys. I'm just telling you my plans openly. And the second thing I talked a lot in this channel about is stock photography. I have 3 videos in stock photography to learn from zero. I recommend you to start right now because yes, you can make money with stock photography. So many people don't believe in it because so many people, they just take a bunch of pictures from the computer, they put them there. However, they don't even worry about keywords and stuff, and they don't sell. You're never gonna sell like that. Like, it's normal you don't believe in stock photography. But you follow my courses, and please feel free to ask me any question. I would be very happy to help. If you follow these 3 videos I'm gonna link below as well, you're gonna learn the whole process and how to do it for you to make real sales. In stock photography, I sold pictures to Microsoft, to Time Inc., to Booking.com, and Condé Nast Traveler as well. I sold to many amazing companies and it's incredible. I'm gonna release soon an interview. Well, they're gonna release an interview. I did like a little interview for Shutterstock, the second one. I did already one, I'm gonna link it below as well. But I did another one actually talking about this, about how you have to do as a photographer to adapt to the new situation. So yeah, stock photography is very, very important. You can make money. At the beginning it's hard. You're gonna sell pennies, literally pennies. But then when you build up the galleries, you're gonna sell more. And if you apply a macro stock photography websites, like Getty Images, Offset Images, and many others out there, you're gonna sell more because the picture when it sells, it's not gonna be sold by £1 or something like that. It's gonna sell for £60, £100 because it happened to me. So maybe you don't sell for a while, but then when you sell, it's £100. And we are all very happy to receive a bit of money in that side. So stock photography is very important. Links below, you have all the videos there well explained. And the third thing I want to focus about, it's about building your online presence. This is key. And this is key because if you don't have traffic and if you don't have an audience, to who you're gonna sell those products. You cannot make a shop online and expect it's gonna sell if you don't have traffic on the website. So please, build your online presence. My favorite platforms is Instagram and YouTube. As you can see right now, by the time you're watching this video, I'm still a small channel, I don't monetize my channel, I don't make even no one penny with this channel. So it is a lot of effort for nothing in theory, but I'm just building up. So start a YouTube channel because you're gonna earn traffic and an audience. Or otherwise, if video is not for you, Instagram. Because in Instagram, you can get as well like brand deals, you can promote yourself, you can do the tutorials there. Now you have a shop in Instagram as well. So when you have a shop online, you can link it with a Squarespace shop and then you can sell your products via Instagram. So I think Instagram is very important. Instagram and YouTube, now I'm pushing a lot with both. Mostly YouTube, to be honest, because I don't have the time to be with both, so don't spread yourself thin. But YouTube, Instagram, build your audience online because that's gonna be super, super good for you to have an audience that supports you and trusts your work and buy your products. Another thing you can do is sign up in Patreon. I do have a Patreon account. Basically, there you would have set up 3 different tiers, or you can set up as many as you want. One normally is very, very tiny. It would be like a donation for your audience to be able to support your work. And people can support your work in exchange of exclusive content. So you have to post in Patreon exclusive content you don't share in YouTube or in another platforms. So those people who decide to support you, they get something from you. They get value and they get extra content. I just have 3 patrons right now, but I'm very happy about it because, to be honest, I'm very small. My audience is not so big by the time you watch this video, at least. And I'm very grateful for them. But one by one, you know, now it's 3. Maybe in the future it's gonna be 20 and maybe 30, and it's gonna support me a lot. So feel free to check it out, by the way. But yeah, you can do a Patreon account. This is more for people who want to start with video. But to be honest, even if you don't want to start with video, I recommend you to do it. Because I hate it. I hated to put myself in front of the camera. I still struggle a lot. But when you learn and you get used to, then you can do Patreon, you can do YouTube, and you can reach your audience better. Because nowadays, video engages, pictures not so much. So it's good you engage with your audience and you can do Patreon. This is another option. The next idea would be selling prints. So many people earn a lot of money with this. I've never tried it myself, I have to be honest, but I may do. What I'm gonna do is first finish the projects I told you before, because I prefer to prioritize the shop and other things before, like YouTube, my Patreon account, and then when everything is more settled, maybe I jump into selling prints. Don't start many projects in the same time because it's not gonna work, you're gonna burn out and you're not gonna end anything. So selling prints, a very good website, it would be Darkroom. They recommended it to me because you don't have to do anything. I mean, you have to do stuff obviously, but it's all online. You don't have to go to a print shop, take the picture, frame it, and then send it yourself. They do everything for you. So I would give it a go in the future, but it's something you definitely should try if you wanna sell your prints, because you wouldn't have to do the whole process, they do it for you. So this is very good, selling prints. And then the last point I wanna talk about, I don't do it yet neither, this last one, but I may do, because I find so many people asking me questions about photography, about my press shots I do for artists, about technique, about lighting. So this is another thing, selling services. If you sell your services online, this is quite easy to set up in your website as well. You would put services and you can teach photography, your photography niche, and you can set up like a price per hour or per 2 hours or per course. This is up to you. And you can install this app called Zoom. Probably you know about it because now everyone uses it because of the lockdowns. So you can set up Zoom, put it in your website, and then someone can hire you and they wanna learn photography from you. And you would have a video conference with that client and you would get your money and they would pay you for your time. And this is a very good thing to do as well nowadays with the lockdowns, because as I mentioned, guys, I don't think 2021 is gonna be any better. And even if it gets better, you never gonna know when they're gonna lock us down again. I'm very disappointed. I've been suffering a lot these months because I've been moving around a lot. If you follow my channel, you know that. And every time I was getting back on track, as I mentioned at the beginning in the intro, then I got messed up again because they locked down everything. Then my clients don't have money, or they postponed because we're in a lockdown. Then maybe I have collaborations with models and I cannot do them because now I cannot meet them, because otherwise the police literally fine you. So it bloody sucks, guys. If you don't adapt, if you don't skill up right now in 2021, you gonna struggle. Don't just wait there, sat down, watching mainstream media for things to get back to normal, because they won't. And again, I'm not being negative, but if they not gonna get back to normal, that's my opinion. And if they do, it's not gonna be that soon. So you better adapt, spend your time, be productive, and learn new things. Please subscribe to my channel and like the video if you really took something nice from it. And I will see you very soon.